Welcome to the CAD Office Training Guide Series for F.Connect. I am Todd Holt, CAD Applications Training Coordinator. Today I'll be going through the Roadway Design Existing Modeling Guide. In this series of videos, I will take you step by step through each exercise from the guide. Today we will start with Chapter 2 of the guide, creating a TDTM RD for the existing ground. This guide will go over the fundamentals of creating a 3D model for existing features to include hard surfaces, examples, asphalt, concrete, sidewalks, curbs, utilities, drainage structures, and soil borings. Participants will be introduced to the Bentley Open Roads Designer Connect Edition Open Roads Technology Tools for design and modeling, specifically for a FDOT project using the F.Connect workspace. Topics for Chapter 2, a GDTM RD file will export the existing ground from the survey and then will import the existing ground into the newly created GDTM RD file. Let's begin. At the beginning of Chapter 2 in the guide, the objective of this chapter will introduce the Open Roads technology tool that will be used for export and import the existing ground terrain from the SURVRD file then into the GDTM RD file and can be used for future modeling. Exercise 2.1, creating the GDTM RD01 file .dgn. We'll open the blank file DGN from the current work set that was delivered or any DGN file within the 220-495-55201 underbar CE work set that we've been in. So right now I have the blank file open and I'm in the current work set of the 220-495. Our first step is to navigate to the F.Dot tab off of the Open Roads Modeling workflow. So we'll select the F.Dot tab. We'll then go to the Actions group and use the Create File tool again. So we're going to click on Create File tool. That'll bring up the Create File application. We will switch our discipline from Roadway the survey, and then the file group will be set to survey design files. We'll then click on the base file name of GDTMRD. That is a digital terrain model and TIN model in 3D. If we wanted to, we could use the modifier for existing ground. The output folder will be in the survey folder. The seed file is preset for us, and then we'll go ahead and select the county. And in this case, it's going to be for Wakulla. That'll set our coordinate system. Once that is set, we're good to go, and we can click Create Open File. Upon creating the file, we'll click Close and move on to Exercise 2.2, Export the Existing Ground by Boundary. The first step is to open the Reference Dialog box. To do that, we can go to the Home tab, go to the Primary group, to the attached tools, or you can do it by the function key of F9. Open up the reference dialog. We'll need to attach the SURVRD file. So we'll go to the tool or attach reference. We can go to tools or just click on the icon of tools. We'll navigate to the project that we're in, 220-495-55201, underbar CE. We're in the survey folder. We want to attach the SURVRD. So we have that selected. We'll click open. That will attach it. I'm going to give it a logical name of GDTM for now. And then click OK. It'll attach the SURVRD with a logical name of GDTM. We'll then fit view. That'll bring it in. And we want to zoom in to the boundary, which is the green dashed line. To clean this up a little bit, we may have to change some levels off. So let's go to our level display, and we can do that from our primary group, from the home tab, primary group, and level display, or also the function key F10 will bring up your level display. So we'll click on the level display. We'll go to the reference of the SURVRD with the logical name of GDTM. And just to isolate everything, we're only interested in the DTM EX and the DTM EP levels. So I'm going to right click and turn all off. And then I'll come back and turn on the EP, DTM underbar EP, and the DTM underbar EX. Once I have those turned on, I'll close the level display. I can close my reference dialog. I'll go back to my element select by escape or F6, or I'll come up to the ribbon. So I want to select my boundary and then hover over it to bring the context menu. And like we said before, you can have three options for the context menu for the boundary. We have the properties, we've seen the set active, and there's also the export terrain model. We want to use this icon or this button here, and that's going to be a split button. So we'll click on the split button to down arrow. We want to use the export method of LandXML, or set up the dialog for the export method. So we'll select, we'll notice we don't have any terrains in here. It's because we don't have it active. Or follow the prompts, filling out the information as necessary. So the project name, we'll put Wakulla for the county. And then the project description, I'm going to put Wakulla and SR61. My export option is going to be set to bold. And then I'm just going to left click and data point through the tool. We'll see if this works. If not, we may have to set the terrain active. And you'll see it's going to give it the name of existing ground, .1XML. I have one previous. So at this point, or I could put a name of, this is going to be the name of the XML. So I'm going to name it existing ground. Since I had one, it's going to put a number beside it and click save. Exercise 2.3, importing the existing ground LandXML. Step 1, detach the servRD file. The reference dialog box can be brought up by the Home tab, the Primary Group, Attach Tools, or the function key F9. I'll select the reference that I want to detach, and then right-click and detach the servRD. Click OK. So now we're back to a blank file. Tab, or the OpenRoads Modeling Workflow. We'll switch from the Home tab to the Terrain tab. We're going to go to the Create Group and then pick on the From File to import our LandXML. We'll click on that. That'll open up the dialog, taking us to the Survey folder so we can pick the LandXML that we just created from exercise 2.2. We'll select the existing ground, one file, or the existing ground, and then click done. That'll bring up the import terrain models dialog. The first step is to set the feature definition. So we'll click on the feature definition dropdown. We'll select the terrain folder and then select the DTM existing feature definition. We'll set the source, the LandXML, the terrain from, the source and definition. We can make this, resize this dialog if we need to. The import options, we want to come in and import the terrain only. And then the source, we'll leave that to the file that we're in. So we need to come and set the feature definition to the terrain folder and pick the feature definition of DTM existing. We're going to build the terrain from the source and the definition. And the import options is going to be set to import terrain only. Once we have those set, we'll click import and then close the import terrain model dialog. And you'll see we have the newly created existing ground in its own file of the GDTMRD02 file. So this file is a cleaner file that can be referenced into any of our new design. We can reference this into an ALGNRD file and create our profiles from it, or we can reference this into any model file and use this as our existing ground instead of the servRD. This will be a cleaner file because the existing ground is the only element information, or the terrain is the only thing in this file. Thank you for joining me today for the CAD Office series for FDOT Connect. This was a chapter 2 from the Roadway Design Existing Modeling Guide.